What's going on, everybody? Crazy Dog back with some breaking Browns news as Andrew Berry strikes again. As according to Adam Schefter, and I quote, Cowboys are finalizing a trade to send wide receiver Amari Cooper and a sixth-round pick to the Cleveland Browns for a 2022 fifth-round pick and a sixth-round pick per league sources. Now, I did say previously that I thought Amari Cooper was our option A, and as it turns out, that was correct. Now, a lot of people thought we would probably wait for the Cowboys to release Cooper, but if we were to wait on Cooper's release, that would give Amari the chance to look at other teams, whereas trading for Amari guarantees that we get him. Now, of course, that contract's a little iffy, but I can imagine Andrew Berry's going to do something with that contract, maybe like give him a new one or something. You know, take the sting out of that contract, because that's a crazy contract he has. That's probably why we got him so cheap. I know a lot of people are like, that's all I got for him? Really? Couldn't get more? I think it's because of the contract, you know. But hey, we got a new number one receiver. Now, you look at Amari Cooper's stats, and yeah, he is a really, really good receiver. Of course, he started off in Oakland, and he was good. You know, while he was there, he had 2,000-yard seasons, and then he was traded to the Cowboys. And of course, he had another 1,000-yard season. And then, since then, with the Cowboys, he's, again, had another 2 1,000-yard seasons in 19 and 20. So, in total, he's had 5 1,000-yard seasons. 2015, 2016, 2018, between two teams, 2019, and 2020. And, of course, this past season, he was about just over 100 yards shy of another 1,000-yard season. He ended at 865 yards, 8 touchdowns. Now, I can already tell you people are going to be on Twitter saying, yeah, he's going from Dak to Baker. Well, the thing is, we've seen how good Baker can be when fully healthy. He's a gunslinger. The thing is, last year, he was dealing with a shoulder injury the entire year that completely messed up his mechanics. If we can get 2020 Baker Mayfield back this upcoming season, I expect Amari Cooper to go absolute berserk. And not to mention, let's say we go out in the draft and we take a certain wide receiver out of Ohio State that just so happened to go to the same high school as Baker, you know, Garrett Wilson. Yeah, that would be fun. Cooper, Wilson, DPJ, Schwartz at receiver. You have Hooper, and then you have Njoku with Bryant at tight end. You have Hunt and Chubb at running back. Man, I swear, if we get all these weapons for Baker and he still sucks, oh my God, he's going to hear it from me. That's for sure. But I like the trade. I freaking love the trade. You know, see what he can do. Now, we've got an update as well regarding Deshaun Watson. By the way, there's Amari Cooper in a Browns uniform, looking good. And then Daryl Ryder actually tweeted this out too. Cooper deal could be the incentive Browns need to get Watson to agree to waive no trade for Cleveland. Yeah, over the past couple days, I've heard the Browns mentioned quite often in regards to Deshaun Watson. Now, if the Browns go out and trade for Deshaun Watson, this would prove two things, really. First one, Andrew Berry was capping when he said that, oh yeah, Baker's a quarterback. But I mean, he just said that just to stave off the questions for the offseason. Because if he didn't guarantee that, if he didn't, you know, put confidence in Baker, like, people were going to be harassing him about it all offseason. So he essentially said, I'm going to just go out and say that Baker's a quarterback just to stave off the questions for the offseason. But of course, he's still gonna look around. I mean, God, he's got a quarterback on a fifth-year option who's coming off an injury. You know, I mean, if he can pull off a trade for Deshaun Watson, bruh, the AFC would become even more of a gauntlet than it already is. Let alone the AFC North. I mean, God. Now, the only thing with Deshaun, though, he could possibly be getting suspended. Even though he's not in any, like, you know, severe legal trouble right now. He's not going to jail. But he might have to spin the commissioner's wheel of discipline. So, see what happens with that. Now, some more things about Deshaun Watson from Dov Kleiman, and I quote, "The Vikings, Seahawks, Panthers, Browns, Bucks, and Saints." So essentially, the Vikings, Seahawks, Browns, and 3/4 of the NFC South have made recent inquiries about Deshaun Watson per PFN. In addition, the Eagles and Niners are no longer interested in Watson after showing interest last year. Okay. So we'll see what develops with this. I expect him to be traded at some point. Probably soon. Maybe to keep the theme going, maybe tomorrow before, legal tampering begins. Or I could see him being traded right as the new league year starts. But I expect Deshaun Watson to be on a new team by week one. Don't know if he'll be playing. Like I said, he still has to possibly spin the wheel of discipline. But we'll see what happens. So, that's pretty much all I got for you. If I hear anything else, I will talk about it. But yeah, Amari Cooper is a member of the Cleveland Browns. Okay. Love to see it. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments down below. I'm Crazy Dog. Let's go Browns. I'll be back later today for my last individual Browns free agency target video. And then, of course, I'll be live tonight for Cavs and Doubles, where hopefully we can bounce back after a hard-fought loss against the Heat. We look good. It's just we just fell off at the worst time. And, of course, the Heat would not miss. It is illegal for our opponents to miss against us. It's absolutely illegal for us to be fully healthy at all at the same time. Always got to have one person out with an injury. It's ridiculous. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up. I'm Crazy Dog. Let's go Browns. And I'm out.